or whatever. And due to the times that we live in today, you know, stuck the road, you know, we had something that would never happen in this county, at least, happen. So you just never know what's going to happen. So the employees have asked, you know, can we have something either on our person or in the ambulance so we can protect ourselves? And, you know, at the time, we don't have a policy for it, so obviously the answer to that question is no. And so, in the course of having our conversations, adding it to the agenda and everything else, I've done some more research to it and whatever, I've consulted with Ken on it, and of course I'll tell you what Ken's opinion is. Ken's opinion on it is no. Ken's opinion on it is, he has no, between all the cities, counties, and ESDs that he represents, he has none of his clients have such a policy. They've explored it, you know, they've entertained it, but they've all, at the end, voted it down, just because of the liability that comes along with it.
Liability.
We're talking about liability insurance.
Talking about, well, for one, if your current insurance provider will even cover you on it, which I don't know if they theirs will or will not. I haven't had the conversation with them, but that is a question to be had. You know, should y'all decide to move forward with anything tonight as far as building a policy, implementing a policy, that would be one of the first phone calls. Insurance company, if we do this, you know, what's it going to cost, or will y'all even cover, you know, such a thing? And if they do, okay, how much, okay. But if they don't, well, then it's going to be, we're going to find a different insurance company. If y'all still chose to move forward.
How many employees do you have that are licensed to carry?
I don't know specifically how many are licensed to carry, but if I had to guess, I would say there's probably 10 or so out there that are licensed to carry. But, you know, some of the policies that I have seen or some of the things that I think should be in policy, you know, would be along the lines of they would have to have, currently have their license to carry in order to carry first off, but then also they would have to take an additional training, firearms qualification, you know, weapons retention.
There is a class out there for them to take.
And your opinion is?
Really?
I'll keep in mind, had this been a live shooter when they showed up over, which is very easy to do, you get a call for an ambulance, you go, you show up, you got a live shooter.
Under normal circumstances, if the call is known to have violence or might go violent, okay, they're going to stage until law enforcement arrives, okay? But in the days that we live in now, we don't know what people are thinking. They may wake up today and say, you know what? I'm going to kill some paramedic. I'm going to kill a firefighter. I'm going to
kill officer. So
hey, I'm going to call in this frivolous call, you know, for abdominal pain just to get an ambulance out here. And as soon as those two paramedics step off that ambulance, I'm going to shoot them. You know, having a gun with them, is it going to prevent that? No. But having a gun with them, it gives them the ability to protect themselves. I get it. I understand that. And I think that's great. But, you know, again, there has to be guidelines, has to be policies and procedures in place, and, you know, as far as, you know, carrying it on your person, you know, when are you going to do it? You know, are you going to allow them to do it out in public? You know, are they going to be able to have it on while they're in the back of the ambulance in a closed quarter with a combative patient, you know, that may have access, you know, to being able to reach up and grab it out of the holster? You know, so those are the liability things that like Ken is talking about, which makes sense. You know, if they are carrying that weapon on their person and they have a, you know, patient that's on bath salts or that is just out of his mind today, he's PTSD, and gets out of your control and reaches up and grabs that gun, then what? Now you're going to have a dead paramedic in the back of the ambulance, you know, or whatever else the tragic case may be. So I can see it both ways.
There's some, non-lethal, or something in the meantime. I don't know.
Well, I mean, I've even heard it talk about being put in a lockbox, and I go back to that and I said, I understand that. That's a good deal. They can't grab it from them, but I said, that's like somebody saying, I've got a gun, but I'm not going to load it until I need to. It's too late.
Well, but here brings up another conversation, okay? I'm sure everybody in this room has heard of the 30.6 and 30.7, okay? And so, this is another thing that the law has done. It sort of has placed an exemption there for emergency response personnel, meaning EMS, okay, if they are responding to an emergency scene, for example, at the school, all right, weapons are not allowed at the school, but an emergency response, they would be exempt from that statute, okay? They would be covered under that umbrella. But now then, let's say they go up there for a PR event, and they have their gun, and they forget to take it off. Now that they just broke the law. See what I'm saying? So,
I tend to be much more, if I go for that, I tend to be much more fair for a concealed weapon rather than an open weapon. I mean, it's strictly from point of getting it taken away from them. Everybody thinks they're bad when they got a gun, but some of them other old boys, they're badder than you are.
Well, I think the purpose of it being on the agenda, okay, is either, it's not to decide one way or the other.
Right.
It's to decide if we want to even move forward and, you know, look at it. Or do we want to just say, no, we're not going to allow that and put this dog to sleep?
I don't know if you're going to be invited to learn more about it. I'm interested in that. So I'll make that motion.
I'll second that motion.
And I don't keep going back to non-lethal, but can we also look at, you know, tasers, possibly carrying tasers, things like that?
She's
got
all those drugs.
He's out.
You didn't vote on it.
We have a motion to have David further investigate this. And put it on next agenda item for next month.